Hello there fellow traveler, what's happening at your end? My name is Tarunama and I welcome you to my travel channel.
In this episode, I'm going to take you to places which are around Jaisalmer and not so popular amongst people, like meeting the emu birds or visiting an underground library. There's much more, so let's begin.
यहाँ पे तो मिट्टी का नाम बनता है इस गली में।
हाँ तो गली का नाम क्या है?
गली का
हाँ
कुम्बारा की पोल।
हाँ
कुम्बारा की पोल,
कुम्बारों की पोल।
So the first place is Pokhran, and right now I'm at Pokhran Fort. So Pokhran basically falls between, you know, Jodhpur and Jaisalmer, somewhere in the middle of these two places. And so about Pokhran Fort, it's partially a hotel as well, so you can, you know, come here and stay at the hotel and also like explore the fort.
After reaching the Pokhran Fort, I had a quick chat with Kavar Param Vijay Singh to gain a bit of insight of Pokhran Fort and its history.
Hi, I'm Param Vijay Singh. I belong to the family of Pokhran. I'm managing and looking after Fort Pokhran, which is our family home. Fort dates back to 14th century, and I'm the 14th generation of the family. We branched out from the Jodhpur family, and a lot of my ancestors are known for their as they were pradhans of the Jodhpur Marwar state, and they have taken, you know, the war glory has been there. They've taken part in various wars in the ancient times, and down the line, you know, we were one of the first families to come into education. So my great-great-grandfather was the first Rajput graduate of the whole of Rajasthan, that time Rajputana, as B.A.L.L.B. And then family turned into politics as the turn of, you know, independence came through. And then my father and later on decided to convert this fort as a heritage hotel. And he gave his entire dedication towards restoring it for its upkeep. He started with the museum in 1987, so he could attract people going towards Jaisalmer. And my mother joined him from 84 onwards, but she was more busy with us as kids, me and my younger sister. And the designing, the interiors of the rooms, the laying out of the gardens to the swimming pool is all my mother's hard work. With my father, you know, giving her all the freedom to use her artistic instincts.
I am just taking a round of the property and it's beautiful. I'm actually enjoying the tour right now. Let me also show it to you. Make sure to halt at Pokhran Fort from your way to Jodhpur to Jaisalmer, as it can turn out to be a great spot for transit.
Alright then, the second place in the list is Kumaro Ki Pol or Kumaro Ki Dhani. So you can come here, buy some pottery work. It's really nice. There are 200 houses in this village and all of them work something with the clay making and, you know, pottery. So visit here, and it's not that far away from Pokhran Fort. So yeah, buy some pottery, come here. It's a nice experience altogether.
Kya kar rahe ho aap, batao zara.
ये मेल उतारने बैठे।
अच्छा, और फिर ये क्या है, इससे क्या कर रहे हो?
बाजरी, बाजरी लगानी पड़ती है।
उस क्यों लगानी पड़ती है?
नहीं लगाएंगे तो ऐसे मेल नहीं उतरता है।
मेल नहीं उतरता? कितना समय लग जाता है इसे बनाने में?
बहुत समय लगता है। बाजरी लगानी पड़ती है, फिर पीटना पड़ता है, फिर ऐसा चेपना पड़ता है।
कितने दिन लग जाते हैं? या एक घंटों में हो जाता है?
एक घंटे में हो जाते हैं, 50 जने।
एक घंटे में 50 हो जाते हैं?
हाँ।
अच्छा,
तो आप यही करते हो फिर?
हाँ।
पीलेंगे ये दूध ही पी लो फिर तो थोड़ा सा।
नहीं चाय चाय बहुत अच्छी है।
चाय अच्छी है। लीला हम कहाँ पर हैं अभी?
किचन में।
किचन में। ये किचन कहाँ पे है आपकी? जगह का नाम क्या है?
पोखरण।
पोखरण। ये कौन सा कोई गांव है क्या है इस जगह का नाम?
शहर
है। अच्छा और ये कॉलोनी यहाँ की कॉलोनी क्या नाम है? इस मतलब पोखरण तो पूरा बड़ा शहर हो गया ना।
हाँ।
तो ये आपका जहाँ घर है उसका उसका क्या एड्रेस है?
यहाँ पे तो मिट्टी का था बनता है इस गली में।
हाँ तो गली का नाम क्या है?
गली का
हाँ?
कुम्हारों की पोल।
अच्छा सो गाइस लीला हैज सो लीला लिव्स हियर एट कुम्हारों की पोल एंड नाउ शी इज मेकिंग मी बकरी के दूध की चाय है ना लीला।
इसको बहुत करना आता है।
शर्मा। सो दैट्स कृष्णा एंड ये हमारी चाय बन रही है।
Leela and her family were generous and welcoming enough to offer me tea and let me record their place. And just like Leela's house, every household in this village is into pottery making. You can also buy tons of decorative items for your kitchen, garden, etc. And do not forget to miss this experience when you visit Pokhran.
ऐसे?
हाँ सही
काटना।
हाँ खींच लो। जाट कैसे खींच लो? मैं बस ये बन गया।
वाह। ये रहा हमारा ग्लास तो थोड़ा टेढ़ा है पर चलेगा।
सो द नेक्स्ट प्लेस इन द लिस्ट इज रामदेवरा विलेज विच इज अबाउट 12 किलोमीटर्स फ्रॉम पोखरण। सो यू कैन कम हियर एंड देयर इज अ टेंपल हियर विच इज डेडिकेटेड टू बाबा रामदेव जी। सो या come here, visit here if you want to, you know, visit a religious place.
Ramdevra temple is sacred to folk deity of Rajasthan, Baba Ramdev ji, a saint of the 14th century who Hindus regard as the incarnation of Lord Krishna while Muslim regard him as Ramshah Pir. Between the months of August and September, people from different walks of life come to attend the Ramdevra fair.
रामदेव जी की बहन सुखना भाई लाचा भाई वो सुखना भाई किसना भाई की हरजी बाटी की पूजा होती है यहाँ पे रामचंद्र समाधि है इनकी पूजा होती है।
Not to forget there's a lake behind the temple where you can go boating as well. The next place in the list is one interesting place in my opinion. So if you've come so far in the video, stick around a little more and get ready to be blown. Bhadariya, a small village in Jaisalmer district, is a home to an unimaginable place. If you or your friend is a bibliophile, then this hidden treasure existing in a remote place of Rajasthan can turn out to be a paradise for you. What's more amusing is that this is one of the Asia's biggest libraries and the credit goes to Baba Harbansh Singh Nirmal ji who was passionate about books and his legacy is still maintained.
Library hai Jagdamba Shiva Samiti Trust ke antargat. Ye trust ke mutabik chalti hai. Aur ye Durga Mata ka Sangya Mata ka mandir hai. Purane samay Dada Maharaj ne banaya tha. Aur Jagdamba Shiva Samiti ek trust hai uske naam pe library chalti hai.
अच्छा
संत हरमन सिंह निर्मल।
अच्छा उन्होंने खड़ी करी।
हाँ उन कलेक्शन उनका है।
उनका कलेक्शन है।
हाँ
और यहाँ पे आपने बताया कितनी किताबें हैं?
ये 3 लाख किताबें होंगी।
3 लाख किताबें और
ये 562 ऐसी रैक है इसमें।
रैक है।
हाँ 18 इसमें रूम बने हुए जिसके अंदर भी पुस्तकें भरी हुई है
जी
और रैकों में पुस्तकें हैं।
और कोई पढ़ने
पढ़ने आते जब हम यहाँ से किताब देते हैं उनको ऊपर एक वाचनालय बढ़ावा उसमें यहाँ पर बैठे
ये पत्ते है लकड़ी के पत्ते पुराने कश्मीर वाले वहाँ की लिखावट है। लिखावट इस प्रकार की इनकी पुरानी 1000 साल पुरानी भाषा आई है।
Oh my god, what is this place? I mean, I've never seen anything like this before. This library is huge, and what is really interesting about this place is this library is in a tiny village on the way to Jaisalmer. So I am surprised. I'm like, guys, you have to add this place in your itinerary and please do visit this place. It's huge, it's lovely. Besides the library, there's Harbhan Singh Ji's Samadhi, Bhadariya Mata Ji's temple, and not to forget a cow shelter. Approximately 19 kilometers before Jaisalmer is Akal Wood Fossil Park, and that's where we're hitting next in the list. So I have arrived at the fossil park. There's no huge board as such on the road to guide you, but there's a small board, which is, one is right there, the other one is right there. So yeah, I have arrived at the fossil park, and there are no people here, but yeah, so let's go. And the park opens at 11:30, and I see the emu bird right there. Wait, let me show it to you guys. I've never experienced such a thing. So guys, you can also come here and watch these beautiful birds. That's it. I don't have any more. And they want food, so that's why they're approaching the car. And we have two emu birds here. I don't know if there are more, but as of now, two. And we have entered the fossil park, the wood fossil park, and now we're gonna go inside. It's a kilometer from here. It was declared as the National Geological Monument of India in 1972 by the Geological Survey of India. And right now, so of course here we have wood fossils, and right now I'm going to check out 180 million year old fossil, and the petrified fossil, so which means basically they're stone like now. Something very different, and the landscape here is pretty amazing actually. And of course I got to meet the emu birds, so yeah, that was pretty fun. And yeah, the fossils are really old and they look all stone like so yeah, if you want, you can add this to your itinerary and come visit this place. I have now reached Tanot Mata Ka Mandir, and let me tell you why this place is so popular. It's because during the war of Longewala, when the bombs were showered at Tanot Mata, the shell never burst, and that is quite incredible in itself. So let's take a glimpse of this place now. It is believed that Tanot Mata is an incarnation of goddess Hinglaj Mata. There's a folklore. Once a man with no child traveled to Hinglaj Mata 7 times on foot to attain a child. On one night, the goddess appeared in his dream to ask what did he want, a son or a daughter, to which the man asked the goddess to take birth in his household. And by the grace of divine goddess, 7 daughters and a son were born at that house. This is another reason why this temple is famous amongst the people of Rajasthan. Not to forget, as you enter inside the temple premises, you may find pictures and unexploded bombshells from the Indo-Pakistan War of 1971. Best part about the road trip for me was driving on the 50-kilometer stretch of Bharatmala Road from Tanot Mata to Longewala. It was a beautiful scenic experience with Thar desert on both sides of the road. Wish I could show you the footage, but unfortunately I lost it during data transfer.
So, without giving it a second thought, get to experience the beauty of Thar Desert by driving on this road, which will also take us to Longewala.
Alright guys, reaching Longewala is the last place in the itinerary of exploring things around Jaisalmer, and the actual border is 15 kilometers from here.
The Battle of Longewala that took between India and Pakistan in 1971 was fought right here in the Thar Desert of Rajasthan. The battle was fought between 120 soldiers of 23 Punjab, escorted by 4 Hunter fighter aircrafts, and between 2-3K Pakistani soldiers, along with Chinese T-59 tanks and squadron of US-built Sherman tanks. At the site, there's a museum and an audiovisual room which takes us through the history of Longewala battle for our better understanding.
Well guys, I think the video is not over just yet, because on our way from Longewala to Sam, we spotted this beautiful looking village, and it's a typical desert village with no pakka houses to be seen from here. So yeah, that is there. It is just next to the road here. So that's it, and with this I'd like to end the video. I'll see you next time, and toodles. Also guys, I request you to please go subscribe to my channel, hit that like button, and share this video with whoever is traveling to Jaisalmer.